from somewhere other than Fort Worth, Texas? Raise your hand. Wow, looky there. That's a lot of folks. Hey, we're mighty pleased to have y'all down here today. You know, down here, I want you to remember in the Stockyards, you're not a tourist, okay? You're our guest, and we're, again, we appreciate y'all being here. Now, you got the marshal out there telling you to stand up, okay? To be on the curb. He actually knows what he's talking about, okay? These longhorns, okay, are real longhorns. They weigh anywhere from 1,500 pounds up. They step on your toes, it's going to hurt bad, okay? And they're just regular animals. So if someone is sitting down or laying down, these cattle will come up to you, okay? So if you have a small child, be sure and ask them to stand up, hold their hands, okay? If you must sit down, we do have benches over here for you, okay? But hey, that's just for your safety, okay? So that's why we insist on that, because we want to take care of you being our guest. Now, after this is over with, oh my gosh, we got some great times for you folks, okay? You saw the marshal coming down the street, okay? He's part of the Texas Legends, okay? They're known all over. They're very famous. They're going to be having a free comedy gunfight right after the cattle drive. So go up the street here underneath the Stockyard Station, okay? You'll see that sign across the street here. Take the railroad track into the building all the way to the back. And I love telling people, hey, it's worth every penny of it. Because it's absolutely free, right? So you can't go wrong there. Now then, after this is over with, boy, if y'all like some good country and western music, we have it for you, okay? Even right now, down on Mule Alley, there's a little place called Second Rodeo, okay? Go inside there. It's a beautiful, beautiful place. It just opened up. You'll love the decor. But in the middle of it, it's got a retractable roof. It's open today. They've got some great country and western singing going on there late tonight. So it starts right now, so go down and get that checked out at 4:30, not long after this, in front of the Coliseum, we're going to be having free music. So check that out, okay? Now, of course, you're in the historic district, right? Every day, we're celebrating over 132 years of Western history here. The Coliseum behind us, for instance, okay? Let's just talk about that for a second. The world's first ever rodeo indoors was held there in 1918, okay? The first bull riding for competition ever was held there. So we are the birthplace of bull riding, okay? The word rodeo itself, which was adapted after the Mexican word for roundup or rodeo, was started there. The first rodeo on radio was there. The first rodeo on TV was held from there. Fort Worth was by far the wildest Western town ever. All of that really got started right after the Civil War when the folks came back from Texas. Our economy was devastated. We had no jobs. The only thing we had of value was some longhorn cattle. We had several hundred around here, but when they went down to Houston and San Antonio, they found our herd numbering over 5.5 million longhorns. Now, they wasn't worth anything here in Texas. There's too many of them. If you butchered one out, you might get $1 to $4. Most people didn't have that. Up north, it was a completely different story. After the war, they were working in factories, making good money. But guess what? They had no McDonald's. See, they had no cattle. They needed cattle. They told the Texans, if we could run 800 miles, they would give us $40 to $50 a piece. Now, that was a lot of money in 1866, folks. They said it couldn't be done, but never, ever tell a Texan they can't do something when money's involved. We're going to figure out a way. Now, these cattle came up the famous Chisholm Trail. By the time they got here, they'd been walking for 6 solid weeks, 400 miles. Now, that was a problem. They were about dead. They need to rest them. So they came to this valley and they would rest them. The normal size of a cattle drive was 18 to 2200, okay? Led by 10 drovers. Talking about drovers, y'all give them a wave, okay? These are the real deal. See their costumes they got on or the clothing? That is authentic from that era, okay? We're the only city in the world that has its own cattle, its own true drovers, and its own branding, okay? And it's called the Flying FW. Now the cattle got here, and the average size was, like I said a while ago, was 18 to 2200. On a normal day, there would be 4,000 to 5,000 head of cattle resting in this valley. People looked from the old fort location about 2.5 miles up the road. They saw nothing but a sea of cattle, and Fort Worth became known forevermore as Cowtown. We never looked back. We finally got a train here in 1876. What better place in this valley, lush with grass and water, to build stockyards? So the stockyards were built. Then in 1902, Swift and Armour said, let's go down to where the cattle are. So they came down here with a dream of building the most modern, efficient, and cleanest plants in the world. In 1902, they did that. We quadrupled in size. We employed a little over 7,000 people down here, and we never looked back. You realize we're now the 12th largest city in the United States? But if you drive around, you're going to see that we still have that old-time feeling about us where we wave at people when we pass them in the cars. When we see people from overseas or even other states come here, we say, hey, you're not a tourist, you're a guest down here. That's the way we roll. So when these steers come down the street, imagine each one of them representing 100, okay? By the way, the average age of a drover, if you weren't aware of it, was 16 to 17 years old. Out of those 10, you would have seen that probably two of them was Afro-Americans. One would have been a Native American. We probably had at least two from Mexico, the greatest cowboys of all, called the Vaquero. By the way, there were women on the trail, okay? You bet Hollywood leaves that out, but they did that job too, right? They didn't always have someone to take care of them. They wasn't gonna all work in stores and women work in the saloons, so they became cowgirls, okay? So they played an important part of our history. In fact, ladies, if you wanna brag a little bit, the largest cattle drive ever was led by a lady called Mary Borland, B-O-R-L-A-N-D, okay? Her husband passed away. Her, along with her kids, made the largest cattle drive ever up the Chisholm Trail. They ought to make a movie about that, right? Absolutely. So folks, one more time, we want to welcome everybody to Fort Worth. We want to welcome you to the stockyards, but most of all, welcome to the cattle drive.
Yeah. Can y'all hear me good?
Yeah.
Do not cross the street. Stay on the side you own. Do not get on the street. Do not sit on the curb.
I bet you, y'all want to be fair. 5 minutes later, I took my battery right over the
phone. You got
take your belt off.
See, look. See, I told you.
Folks, after this cattle drive's over, my old granddaddy said if you ain't got a picture, it didn't happen. So y'all get over here, get you a picture made on this old longhorn, okay?
I have a massive heart attack before it ever got done.
Hey, y'all smell the cowboy?
Yeah, he's cute too. Look at him. Ooh, look at them.
In fact, Mallory getting the cowboy.
Why is he even taking it?
There's Linda.
Hello. Here's a souvenir for you.
Thank you.
Right.